we are in week five of isolation. And I couldn't just do a carpool karaoke by myself this week, so I'm practicing social distancing and using the church bus. And I've put Pastor Creighton Alexander approximately 6 feet behind me.
Yeah, we're okay.
We're pretty close. Welcome aboard, Pastor Creighton. I'd love for you to tell us what your job is at the church. What do you do?
Well, it's the biggest title ever. I'm the executive pastor of outreach and operations. One part of that is helping the church mobilize and be the church in the world. One thing we're doing right now during this pandemic is we've got about 45 volunteers that are helping with four sites for feeding kids in the Chapel Hill Carborough School District. So proud of those people. So proud of what we're able to help with the rest of the faith communities. That's kind of our big push right now. Then the operations part is helping with the church running day to day, from Sunday services to our programming that takes place during the week. What's been amazing about this last 5 weeks in the pandemic is watching this creative staff that I get to work with come up with all new programming as we're trying to reach people when they're not there.
That sounds like a really big job. And you know, most people kind of forget how much church happens between Sundays, right?
We're not just working on Sundays.
That's right. So I'm wondering if you had one simple message that you could get out to everybody during this isolation, what might that message be?
You are not alone.
Oh, that's a really great message. Maybe there's a song that can help us think about how to get that out.
There just might be.
Just a castaway, an island lost at sea, oh. Another lonely day, no one here but me, oh. More loneliness than any man could bear. Rescue me before I fall into despair, oh. I'll send an SOS to the world. I'll send an SOS.
Have been there's five of you in your family plus a handful of dogs, right?
Right, and two cats.
Yeah. So all in all, a lot of mammals in the household.
Yes.
All quarantined together. So right. What have you guys been doing to kind of like cope with the stress of being all hunkered down together?
You know, we love being outdoors. We've got a fire pit that we're out almost every night. We've got hammocks hung around the trees for people to just relax in. And we've been singing that Baby Yoda song a lot.
Baby Yoda song? I hear that he's really cute.
Oh, he's adorable. Man, I wish the kids were here to help me sing that song, though.
Yeah, I would love to hear it.
Baby Yoda. Baby Yoda. Baby Yoda. Look into his eyes. Now tell me how you feel inside. Shaking like a soda, I turned emotionally flat to the real world, cause you a soldier who would turn home to his mama. Yes, I'll be your mama every night you come on TV. I will feed into your drama. That was a little weird, and that I do say I'm sorry. Sorrows got me in my feelings, but the others feel so strongly that if anything happens to you, know that they would sue. Disney Plus would go down under, bankrupt just because of you. You're more than a man to me. Every time I might die.
baby
you guys,
Yoda.
That was beautiful.
That
was
Where'd that come from?
Truly beautiful.
We're ninjas.
Well, Whitby, Cannon, Cosmo, it's nice to have you on board.
Thank you for having us.
Yes, thank you for keeping your social distance from me. Yeah, I greatly appreciate it.
Of course.
So, Creighton, I wonder if you, when you look back on the pictures of your own babies and you compare them to Baby Yoda, which ones are more likely to make you cry?
Man, my kids got Baby Yoda beat.
Oh, that's so sweet. Mine don't. Oh, I'm kidding. But seriously, they don't with them.
Okay.
All right, thank you all for coming. Make sure that you clean your hands before leaving.
Yeah.
All right, squirt.
Thank you, Charlie. Bye-bye.
Bye, guys. Bye, Whitby.
Charlie?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
The air from your mouth is on my hands.
All right. See you guys.
Bye.
Love you guys.